Mumbaistan. The launch will happen a little later, once hopefully Ms. Ekta Kapoor joins us. But for now, on the dais, with an encouraging round of applause, please join me in welcoming the author of the book that we're launching today in Mumbaistan, Piyush Jha, everybody. An encouraging round of applause for him. Joining him on the dais, we also have some noted personalities. We have renowned director Sudhir Mishra. Sudhir Mishra ji, can we have you on stage, please? We also have a very, very talented young actor, Arunoday Singh. And we have MLA Krishna Hegde with us as well on stage. Sudhir Mishra, Arunoday Singh, Mr. Krishna Hegde, along with the author of the book we're launching today, Piyush Jha, with his book Mumbaistan. Before we do the official launch, we're just waiting for Ekta to be here with us. In the meanwhile, we thought, why not let everybody in the audience get a taste of what's in store for all of us. Now, this book is like three explosive crime thrillers, and what more can you ask for in a single book? We'd like Piyush to just tell us a little more about it. You know, this is his first book, and to have not one, but three thrillers, and that three crime thrillers, and with a title that says Mumbaistan, I'm assuming the story centers around our city, Mumbai. So I'm sure the book has various nuances, various shades of black, white and grey. And we'd like Piyush to tell us a little more about it. Piyush.
Can anybody hear me? Okay, first of all, we'd like to apologize for starting late. But, you know, it's all because of the rain and also because we were just waiting for our friends all to come because traffic is horrible. So thank you very much for waiting. I think I see all my friends who are all around the place. Sudhir has given an interview. So everybody is like being very accommodating, and thank you very much, everybody. So please, everybody, gather around for the thing that you've come for.
Well, the launch is going to happen shortly.
Yeah, it'll be fine. And I'd like to say, John, please, John. No, come here. Come. Mr. John Matthew Mathan, the director of one of my favorite films, Sarfarosh, he's right out there. He's one of our Rahul Dholakia, J.D. Majithia. Everybody, please come, join us in the chairs out here, don't stand. No, Justin Uday are there to keep it company. The music directors of Mumbaistan, the song that you all heard, they are there. I'm waiting for Sudhir to finish his interview and join us. You see, the Sudhir is very interested in always, whenever there's a camera, there's Sudhir. Don't we all know that? I just want to tell you all, thank you very much for coming out here. Mumbaistan has been a year's journey, a year and a half's journey. I started writing a script, and what happened was, as I was writing that script, the idea of crime thrillers started happening in my head. In small, short story forms. So I didn't know what to do with them. I felt that I should kind of start writing them in some way or the other. So I started writing them as stories and instead of scripts, and the result was Mumbaistan. I'm going to tell you a lot more about it, but I would love that right next to me, we'll have the chief guest, Ekta Kapoor, who's going to be joining us in the next 3 or 4 minutes, and also Sudhir Mishra. So once that happens, I'm going to start it. Till then, if you don't mind, bear with us for another 5 minutes. We're going to start in another 5 minutes. Right? Thank you. While I was thinking, I started thinking of a song too. Ah, here we have Ekta Kapoor.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Our chief guest for this evening, Ekta Kapoor, please welcome.
Round of applause, everybody. Our chief guest for this evening, Ekta Kapoor.
Ekta is here, we'll start with the proceedings in right earnest. So, the first thing that I'd like to do is, I'd like Arunoday to read, I know he just started his coffee, but, you know, to read out a passage from the book. Now, Arunoday, as you know, is an actor, and he'll try to infuse his skills in the writing, but...
It's not gonna happen.
Okay.
I'm just gonna read it. Chosen is one I very much like. It's from the first novella in the collection called Bombay. At that very moment, inside a Chira Bazaar jewelry shop, Rabia's keen eyes were inspecting an exquisite green crystal floral motif crafted into the heart-shaped centerpiece of an exquisite Kundan Chumar, one of the most coveted ornaments for a Muslim bride. Pinned on one side of the bride's hair, the flowing Chumar, with its special gem setting, lends her a dignified communal identity. This particular jewel was on display at Popular Jewels, one of the smallest but oldest jewelry shops in Chira Bazaar. Popular Jewels had earned a reputation for being one of the last few shops that provided superb traditional craftsmanship at affordable prices. The owners were known for their honesty, but on the flip side, the shop also had a reputation for a laid-back attitude towards security. It was therefore not a shock when a gangly, well-dressed young man walked into Popular Jewels without being stopped. He had been following Rabia ever since he had received the tip-off from the bank manager. He sauntered up to her and without warning snatched her Rexine handbag off the glass top counter where she placed it while trying on the jhumar. Rabia blinked, confused, not understanding that's what such a well-dressed young man would want with her bag. But when the man loped towards the exit, she displayed an alertness alien to her otherwise languid nature. She rose, screamed, "Jor, Jor!" and with a speed only seen in professional sports persons, sprang behind the thief, who had just about managed to reach the exit door. The store's lax attitude was on full display. The security guard's chair by the door was empty. And as a considerate afterthought, the guard had left behind his antique 12-bore rifle, propped against the wall, perhaps hoping that its presence would deter a thieving mind. In fact, this kindly act was what saved the day. Rabia, chasing after the thief, grabbed the rifle instinctively and emerged with it onto the crowded street. The sight of a burqa-clad woman brandishing a 12-bore rifle on the busy street, combined with her screaming, "Chor!" had its effect. Most passers-by leapt right out of the way. Fearing for their lives, they ducked down to avoid any errant bullets.